If words like Medusahead and Ventenata sound scary or foreign, you'd be right. They're a pair of non-native invasive grass species that recently showed up on the landscape in parts of Wyoming, with the potential to adversely affect habitats wildlife and livestock depend upon. Recently, the University of Wyoming Department of Plant Sciences held an informational gathering and habitat tour of one of the affected areas in Sheridan County to bring habitat biologists, landowners, and the public up to speed on the discovery. Dan Tekela is the invasive plant extension specialist at the University of Wyoming.
Medusahead and Ventenata are very similar to cheatgrass, which I think most people at least have heard in passing. The problem with these two species is where cheatgrass has already left the barn and we're going to have it for the rest of time within Wyoming. Ventenata and Medusahead are very new species and we still have potential to manage these two species.
How the two grasses arrived in Wyoming is unknown, perhaps on the shoes or tire treads of somebody visiting the state. Both plant species are native to the Mediterranean region. Ventenata was first reported in the U.S. in 1952. Medusahead detected in Oregon back in 1887. They're similar to ordinary annual grasses and hard to really identify, but their impacts to wildlife and livestock habitats are noticeable. They outcompete native plants and vegetation, have the same potential impact fire has with cheatgrass, and neither big game nor livestock find them palatable.
They reduce biodiversity, which from the standpoint of our state where we have lots of great wild areas where we appreciate our biodiversity, that's a real potential. And if we talk about big game, so you're talking about mule deer, elk, things like that, both the species reduce forage quality greatly.
As cheatgrass has the ability to take over landscapes, these two grasses invade different areas where cheatgrass isn't as aggressive and can take over that area. It's hard to expect the public to be able to identify or be looking for these two invasive grasses, but they can keep it from spreading.
I think the general public should be more worried about not moving them or not moving species in general. So we have a campaign within the state called Play Clean Go, and it's just the idea that before you leave a site after some type of recreation, whether it be on your ATV, hiking, hunting, that you ensure that you clean off your equipment, your boots, your animals, so that you aren't moving seed to new areas.
Controlling these grasses with herbicides is doable, but as with cheatgrass, costs to effectively control them are expensive on a large scale. For information on how you can identify these grasses and help control the general spread of invasive plant species, visit www.wyoweed.org. This is Ray Hageman with the Wyoming Game and Fish Department.